Okay, everyone, pick up a new boat here, new project boat for myself. And what I got here is an 87 Arima Sea Chaser, 17 foot. Starting the bow here. Has a windlass. Nothing on this boat I've checked out yet, so I have no idea what works, what doesn't work. It also has this huge spotlight. That's pretty interesting. It has this winch system. It looks like it's a like an automatic winch system or something. I've never seen it, but the trailer is a trip too, because it has like this little thing here that interesting coupler. Never seen one like that before. Let's take a look here. The hull. The hull's in really good shape. You can see it's just really oxidized. But barely even looks like it's even seen the sand. Has never been on the beach or anything like that. Trailer's gonna need some work. It's dogging to the right, so I have to figure out that one after a while. Take you around over here. It has dual brake lights. And another one has two kicker mounts. An old 87 Johnson 90 VRO. I gotta check it out, see if it's gonna work and all that great stuff. And it has a little 9.9 kicker. Has these little guys here, not sure exactly what they are. I'll figure that out later. Come around. Has downriggers. Good looking into that. And then they have had this thing sitting on sides. Actually, there's two of them. There's one on this side and one on the other side. Let's check inside here. Must be a raw water pump hooked up somewhere. Back to the side to check out the other hatch. It's the other downrigger. Looks like it gets some old mail in here. Check that out. That's pretty cool. It has the original little latches there. That's cool. Go back to the other side here. And as you can see, definitely it's gonna need some work. I'm gonna take all the pinstriping off here. All this is gonna go. Looks like I'm gonna have to drill out these because they're all riveted in. So I'll be taking all those out, filling them in, and going over it. Up here. This is broken here. Looks like another possible VHF antenna or probably a radio antenna. Didn't put any clamshells over, so the holes are all open here. Some buoys, little holders for them, pretty interesting. See a little better the spotlight here. This is going to be coming out. Anchor sitting up on the top. Has a spare. Still looks really good on the side. Let's go take a look on the inside. Okay, welcome to the inside. So here we can see the wiring mess. All the wire is gonna come out of here. I'm gonna rip everything out. I'm gonna have to catalog each one to figure out what is what. You can see the Johnson Bureau oil can here. I tell you, everything's a lot bigger in this boat compared to my 16. Seems like it's gonna be a lot easier to get in and out of this thing. Let's check out the fuel tank. You can smell the old gas in here. Definitely, you can smell it's old. And gonna need to get a new fuel hose here. That one's no good. I'm pretty much probably gonna replace all the hoses. Gotta take a look inside the tank later on, see if there's any gas even sitting in there. Guessing this is the little reservoir for the oil for the kicker. Here's one of the downriggers. Oh, here's the other one, riding right behind it. With the bimini top. Oh, this must be to connect the motors. This must be to connect the motors here. And got a seat here. It's actually really good condition the seat is in. Surprised, actually. Bimini top. It's pretty cool. Has little deck lights. There's one here and one over here. Looks like they're, yeah. Check that out. Here's some more seats. Seats are in actually really good condition. Really wasn't expecting that. Look inside here. Looks like probably a mount for maybe a handheld VHF. Wiring goes back in there. And what do we got over here? It says structure scan, Lawrence. Look into that. I have to figure out if all this stuff works. I think this was a couple fire extinguishers. Check this out. A cassette player. I think last time I had a cassette player was when this boat was made back in 87. That is funny to see. Antique, maybe? Cigarette lighters, all the cable for stuff. Looks like some kind of clock or something on the dash here. All the gauges. Who knows if they work or not. But I'm getting rid of all this vinyl. That's all going to go. Get some ABS board in there. And I'm guessing that's a light. This is battery power. Check that out. Some really cool speakers. This thing probably thumps. Another thing went here. Looks like probably the VHF radio went in here. And what we've got here. Oh, that must be for the windlass. That's for, I don't know. And this here says, looks like a battery charger. It's pretty cool. And then, I don't know what this guy was for. Okay, let's go inside. Okay. Alrighty. Well, we got more seats in here, a ladder. Got a hose that who knows what it's for. Some road, some vinyl. You know what? I think that's the cover for the boat. That's pretty cool. If it is, then I am pulling out those snaps. And another, that just looks like a regular boat cover. What kind of goodie do we have behind here? Yeah, it looks like a. Another piece of history, so looks like the VHF radio. I really gotta get in here and pull everything out later on, but I just wanna check it out. So, that's pretty cool. All this wood is gonna be either swapped over to starboard, or I'm going to finish it a different way. Really needs some attention, so that's going to be a hell of a lot of work on there if I don't swap it out. Check it out, there's the horn. Or this thing has a few horns. The switch panel, that will be definitely getting changed up. Well, here we go, now we can see the hours. Wow. Almost 1800 hours on the main. For 87, I guess that's not too bad. Don't know what it is on the kicker. Check this out. You got the hailer, some dual horns, regular horn right here. Got the VHF antenna. Kind of see up here on the deck. You got the fish holds. Checked in there earlier, nothing. I didn't check inside the cooler. Let's see what's in here.
Yeah, more dirt.
There you go. That is the grand tour of this. So next stop is going to be pulling out all of this wiring, which there is a lot of it. And then get this gas tank pulled out, get it cleaned out. Like I said, I can smell the varnish gas in here. And then I'm gonna go through and give this boat a good detail. She needs a cleaning. It is oxide. I think the last time this thing was washed and waxed was back in 87. What's this? Fuel for the kicker. That's what I'm guessing. Mount for a fish finder. Oh, I forgot to even show you this awesome thing. Almost forgot the other antique. Let's get back in here. Check this out. Oh yeah. That's like an original fish finder. I have no idea if that is from the 80s, 90s, or what. There you go.